Hi everyone! Today, I'll walk you through this sales team's dashboard designed to help you analyze and track your sales team's performance with just a few clicks. Let's dive into the dashboard. At the top right, you'll find the fiscal year selector to choose the year you want to review, and the benchmark selector to compare against budget, forecast, or last year. Once you've made your selections, we'll begin on the left, where you'll find the total sales, team count, and agent count for the selected fiscal year. Below the sales figure is the percentage variance against the selected benchmark, and beneath the team and agent count, you'll see their year-over-year changes. This provides a quick, high-level snapshot of overall sales team performance. The team analytics sits at the center of the dashboard, offering a clear view of overall performance. It includes a summary line displaying the total variance for the selected fiscal year, highlighting whether sales are exceeding or below the selected benchmark. The chart uses black bars for actual sales and gray bars for benchmark figures, making it easy to compare performance at the team level. Hovering over any bar displays the team name, actual sales, benchmark figures, and variance. This chart serves as a focal point for reviewing individual team performance. Clicking on the team name updates the entire dashboard to reflect the selected team metrics. Then, at the bottom left, we have the sales performance displayed as bubbles on the map. Hovering over a bubble reveals the city name, actual sales, benchmark, and variance. Clicking on a city zooms in on its data, refreshing the entire dashboard. This map provides a geographic view of sales distribution, with bubble sizes helping you quickly identify high and low performing regions. To the right of this map is the sales trends over time. This line chart compares monthly actuals to the selected benchmark for the fiscal year. Move your cursor over any point to get a quick look at that month's sales data. Finally, on the right, we have the detailed view, allowing you to focus on either product or agent. As with the other charts, black bars represent actual sales, and colored variance lines show the difference from the benchmark. This makes it simple to identify top performers. Clicking on any item also refreshes the dashboard for a deeper analysis. This dashboard is designed to provide a clear and structured view of sales team performance, from an overview to detailed insights. If you like what you're seeing so far, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now, let me show you how to make this dashboard yours in three simple steps. Step 1. Download the template. Start by downloading the Power BI template and the Excel dataset using the link in the description below. It's completely free and easy to access. After downloading, extract the files from the zip folder, and you're done with step 1. Step 2. Replace the dataset. Before getting to the Excel dataset, here's a quick overview of the data structure. The main data table sales contains key sales data, such as sales date, city code, product ID, agent ID, metrics, and the sales figures. The next four tables, team, agent, product and region are dimension tables. They provide information specific to the organization and categorize the data for dicing and slicing. These tables are linked via key fields, enabling the dashboard to provide comprehensive sales insights. Now, let's open the Excel file. We'll start with the fiscal year setup. In the parameters worksheet, select the start month of your reporting period from the drop-down list. The file will automatically populate the fiscal end month below. Note the end month number highlighted in green, as you'll need this later when updating the BI file. The second worksheet, select FY, updates automatically according to the selection at the parameters worksheet. No changes are required here. The next worksheet, sales, contains the core sales data. Replace this sample data with your actual sales records. The next for worksheets, team, agent, product, and region contain data specific to your organization. Update them with your own information, and that's it for the Excel file setup. Step 3. Load your data to the BI template. Open the BI file in the Power BI desktop. If you don't have Power BI Desktop yet, download it free from the Microsoft website. The link is in the description. For those interested in building the entire dashboard from scratch, I have a time-lapse video that walks through the process. Click the link above to watch. Now, to replace the data file in Power BI, click on the Transform Data button to enter the query view. To adjust the data source settings, click on the Data Source Settings button at the top. Select the file shown, then click on Change Source. Browse and navigate to the folder where you saved your dataset, and the BI file will automatically update with the new data. While still in the query view, update the reporting period. Click on Dim Date on the left side of the screen, then under the Applied Steps on the right side, click on Fiscal Year and Month. This template is showing 12 as it was set up for the reporting period from January to December month. To adjust it, click on the bar, enter your end month number, and press Enter. Once you are done, click on the last line under the Applied Steps. To exit query view and load your data, go to the top left corner and click Close and Apply. Give it some time to load your new data. And there you have it! With these steps, you'll have your customized sales team dashboard that helps streamline your sales analysis, giving you quick interactive insights at every level. Going forward, you just need to update the Excel worksheet and click the Refresh button at the top to update the dashboard with the latest data. I hope you find this sales team dashboard template helpful for your work or learning. If you are looking for more dashboard templates, be sure to check out my earlier videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.